Hi, today I'm going to give a book review about the book Bear Grylls Adventures, The Desert Challenge. Chief Scout Bear Grylls is going to guide Sophie through the desert. This book was authored by Bear Grylls and illustrated by Emma McCain. Sophie is our girl who has enrolled herself into the wildlife camp. So she is in the wildlife camp now, and she is afraid of every insects, wasps, crickets, caterpillars, worms, beetles and other buzzing insects, everything, reptiles like snakes and other slithering things, everything. She doesn't like to be with that insects and other things. But what can she do? Because she is in the wildlife welfare summer camp, and she cannot escape it because she likes the other fun activities in the camp. And on one day she encountered a long daddy long leg insect, which is sort of a spider like thing. She doesn't want others to know about her weakness or fears. Unfortunately, she screamed and a boy noticed that, and he gave a compass to her. The next day Sophie participated in the relay race, and her turn is about to cross a sand pit using a zip wire. She has to sit on a zip wire which has a button seat, and she is running for the yellow team, and the other guy here runs for the red team. While crossing this zip wire, she saw a cobweb. Because she doesn't want to encounter that cobweb, she just want to tilt herself, but unfortunately that tilt made her to get imbalanced, and she fell down over the sand pit. While she was trying to get up from that sand pit, she found something different. There she found the soil is totally different, and there is no moisture in that soil, and it is totally dark yellow, and the sun is like scorching her. It is trying to bake her brain out. And there she saw a person sitting under a palm tree near the water pool, and of course she is in desert now, and the place they were standing is oasis, so they can quench their thirst in that oasis. He told he will guide her through this desert, so she is getting ready for the desert with the suitable things. And while she was walking, she found a scorpion which will give a sting, which is very very painful but not that much lethal or deadly, but she has to avoid it. And one thing you need to know is the desert's heat, so to avoid such heat and the sun's glaring on your eyes, you can apply something under your eyes. That means you can apply the mud under your eyes so that the sun's reflection, sun's glare will be reflected away using this mud. Then she was given a shimak. A shimak is the clothing that will just cover everything, your head and face, except there will be a slit for your eyes to view. In the desert, one must wear a loose fitted cloth just to allow the air to pass through freely. In West Africa, there is a people called Tuareg tribes. They usually wear blue colored clothes to avoid the sun's glare, and they don't want the sun glare to be absorbed, rather than they want that to be reflected. So they wear always blue colored clothing while they were traveling through the desert. And this is to one of the trick many tribal people use. In the desert, water is the most precious resource. One must preserve it every time and must use it very stingily. There is a tribe in Mexico called the Tarahumara tribe. They gave a beautiful way to use the water very efficiently. One must drink the water but shouldn't swallow it. They must keep it inside their mouth so that that water will be seeping through inside their throat later with less speed, but you will stay hydrated all the time. Deserts don't have clouds, so once the sun sets off, the desert will become colder and sometimes coldest. So, to avoid the bone-eating cold, there are some tricks that must be followed inside the desert area. The rocks in the deserts are the best radiators, which will radiate the heat during the night time. So, under the rock, there are many creepy crawlies. One must check for it. And there are different types of things you must deal with. They took rest in the body. There, Sophie encountered a large, deadly, venomous snake called the puff adder. Sophie dealt with that animal very carefully. She just called help from Bear Pills, but she didn't try to move. Soon, very soon, they take off from that place and they try to find water source under a thorn bush, and they found some water. While searching for water under the thorn bush, Sophie found herself. She is not afraid of that snake anymore, and she thought she got control over herself when she encounters such a type of reptiles. She realized the fact. She immediately came back to that sandpit area. Again, she found herself running in the relay race. Every child can relate themselves with this story. It is very interesting, and you can learn few facts about this desert. And definitely, I will recommend you to read this book, and it is very interesting. And I will also add the link in the description box. If you find this video interesting, please like and comment. And also, you can share this video. And please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't.